Hello everyone, today I want to talk to you a bit about Five Nights at Freddy's. The third game just came out not too long ago, and there are a lot of rumors spreading around about the game's hidden, horrifying story. Now, what I have to share with you is the information I have found online over the past couple of days about all three Five Nights at Freddy's games.
You can find links to all of my sources in the description below.
Just so you know, this story I'm about to tell you is definitely not 100% accurate. It could all be completely wrong or completely true. We won't know for sure until more information about these games are released. Also, before I start, I would like for you to keep in mind that there are five places mentioned throughout the Five Nights at Freddy's games.
Fazbear's Family Diner,
three Freddy Fazbear's Pizzas, and Fazbear's Fright, the Haunted Attraction. I have broken the story down into five sections, so you can skip ahead if you want to, or you can watch the entire story as one full narrative. Other than that, sit back and relax as I tell you the full story
of Five Nights at Freddy's.
Once upon a time, in the mid-1970s, there was a place called Freddy Fazbear's Diner, which was opened by a kind and sweet couple who loved children and starred an animatronic called Freddy Fazbear. In this place of fun and joy, families and children would be entertained by Freddy Fazbear and his animatronic friends, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy, and other adorable characters. One day, while business was good and customers were happy, a small child stared through the window of Freddy Fazbear's Diner. He wanted so bad to join in on their fun and games, and slowly tears began to run down his face and blur his vision. As the child sobbed silently, alone and unprotected, he never took notice of a car pulling up behind him. With a heavy heart, the boy tried to calm himself down and wiped the drops from his tear-streaked face. As his vision began to clear, he noticed something purple in the reflection of the window, and it was growing closer to him. Before the child could turn around for a better look, the cold hand of death swept across him, and the last thing he saw was the smiling faces reflected in the window of Freddy Fazbear's Diner. This was the first incident of several murders yet to come. The man in purple quickly fled from the scene, and police were left baffled by the incident, resulting in the cancellation of Freddy Fazbear's Diner. Rights to the restaurant and the animatronics were then sold off to a new company named Fazbear's Entertainment. Fazbear's Entertainment later opened its very first restaurant in the 1980s called Freddy Fazbear's Pizza. This restaurant was quite successful and brought many young children to its residence. The murderer of the first child was thrilled he could get away with such a dastardly deed and decided he would try something harder, something more sinister. So the purple man applied for a job at the newly opened Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, and he was hired as a night guard. Another man was also hired as an employee. His name was Phone Guy. After working hard for the restaurant and inspecting the layout of the building, he discovered that there were no cameras in the hidden back room of the building. No place for wandering eyes to follow him. So after a while, the purple man decided to finally put his master plot into action. One evening, the murderer went to the back room and found that there were several old animatronics that were stowed away in there due to their malfunctioning nature. He picked out one of these suits that was gold and resembled the main mascot of the franchise, Golden Freddy. The purple man then proceeded to the main room where he was able to catch the attention of five children at a birthday party. Then the man entertained and played with the children, slowly luring them to the back of the building. When at last he reached the hidden room, he pushed the children inside with the old animatronics and shut the door behind him. The children began to realize that something wasn't right, but they were too late. One after another, the five children were killed, and their bodies were left on the hard concrete ground, surrounded by the animatronics they loved. Minutes after their death, someone else entered and discovered the dastardly deed. This was the spirit of the first dead child. This ghost was filled with sorrow and had a thirst for revenge against the Purple Man. So he inhabited the body of one of the older animatronics left in the room, the puppet, and decided to stuff the five animatronics, Freddy, Chica, Foxy, Bonnie, and Golden Freddy, with the children's five corpses. This gave new life to the cuddly characters and a possible means of them getting revenge on the Purple Man. The restaurant continued to do well, as four of the suits, Freddy, Chica, Foxy, and Bonnie, were still set to work. But as the months passed, customers started to smell foul odors coming from the animatronics, and some even swore they saw blood oozing out of them. The restaurant was then shut down due to health conditions, and the animatronics were turned off. However, the children's spirits were still left inside, and the restaurant was left to rot. In 1987, a brand new Freddy Fazbear's Pizza was built, Freddy Fazbear's Pizza 2. This building's layout was much larger than the first Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, and a brand new line of animatronics called Toy were made to continue to bring joy and happiness to children. Also, the older animatronics of the last restaurant were brought over with the children's bodies mysteriously removed, and then were revamped with new technology. However, while the new models kept customers happy, the older models would often malfunction, so they were not allowed to roam during the day and were left lying around in the back rooms as spare parts. However, at night, when the lights went out, all of the animatronics would roam the building, whether they were supposed to or not. Six of them were on the hunt to find their murderer. For you see, none of the spirits knew what the Purple Man looked like, since he was only seen through a window and inside a costume. That was until Freddy Fazbear noticed something while walking around the compound one night. He found the security guard hiding the remains of what was left of five other dead children. Freddy Fazbear didn't know how or when the Purple Man struck again, but he needed to stop him. Quickly, he tried to attack the guard, but the murderer had a device in his hands and was able to escape. With five more children gone, and the murderer finally discovered, once again, the puppet put the five new dead children into the new five toy animatronics. Due to the events of the night before, the Purple Man realized that at least one of the animatronics knew that he was a night guard, and that animatronic would most likely hunt him down, if given the chance. So he quickly called the manager and asked for a daytime position at the company instead. He is given the switch, and a new night guard named Jeremy is hired to take over the new position of the night guard. While Jeremy is on watch, he notices that the animatronics are very hostile towards him, and as time passes, other adults working at the restaurant have noticed that the animatronics were becoming hostile towards them as well. The police at last intervene, informing the owners that there were five missing children, and tells them they want to conduct an investigation of the restaurant. They discover the Golden Freddy suit and suspect it was used to murder several children. So the restaurant was most likely going to be shut down for good. But before that, there was one last birthday party to be held. The night guard, Jeremy, was asked to take part in the birthday party and was told to make sure that none of the animatronics would hurt anyone due to their abnormal behavior. On the day of the birthday party, Jeremy put on his night guard uniform and came in early to attend the birthday party. As the families were entertained, one of the toy animatronics notices that Jeremy's outfit was the same outfit as their murderer. Without hesitation, the cuddly character bit off half of Jeremy Fitzgerald's head, instantly killing him. This incident was the final straw for Freddy Fazbear's Pizza 2, and later became widely known as the Bite of 87. Despite the events of the last two restaurants, a third and final restaurant was opened, Freddy Fazbear's Pizza 3. This building was smaller, half the size of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza 2, due to their low budget. The newer toy models of the animatronics as well as the puppet were destroyed due to the Bite of 87. The only ones kept were the older models, Freddy, Bonnie, Chica, and Foxy, which were once again revamped since the restaurant could not afford another new line of animatronic models. The spirits of the toy animatronics left for the afterlife since they no longer had bodies for revenge, but the spirit of the puppet stayed with the children still left in the old animatronics and haunted the new building, often changing the posters on the walls to try and inform someone somewhere that the evil man was still on the loose so that future children could be saved from the same terrible fate. While this new restaurant was getting started, they needed a new night guard to watch over the premises, so they asked one of their best employees who had been with the company for many years, Phone Guy. On his shifts, Phone Guy would create messages for future employees, telling them about the job and a bit of backstory behind the company. One day, while making some of his final recordings, Phone Guy didn't notice one of the animatronics getting dangerously close to him. Golden Freddy unexpectedly attacked Phone Guy and killed him. After ending Phone Guy's life, the spirit inside of Golden Freddy is satisfied that his deed has been done and leaves for the afterlife. The murderer finds out about the death of Phone Guy and realizes that they have been attacking the night guards. He becomes terrified that he might be next. With the second murder of an employee, the restaurant chain of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza was most likely going to be discontinued for good. While closing time was underway, Purple Man snuck into Freddy Fazbear's Pizza for the last time. While the sun still lingered in the air and the animatronics were turned off, the murderer proceeded to board up all of the doors to the building. He then hid in the back room where one of the last remaining animatronics from Freddy Fazbear's Diner was kept for spare parts, and there he waited. After night finally set in and the animatronics started to turn on, one by one, they made their way towards the back room. Once they were close enough, Purple Man jumped out of his hiding spot and destroyed them all. With their metallic bodies and mangles, the four spirits left the animatronics but did not proceed to the afterlife. The murderer couldn't be happier. At last, everything was destroyed. All the evidence was gone forever, and he could leave without a care in the world. But he couldn't. Blocking the exit to the back door were four ghost children, all lined up in a row. The Purple Man was terrified. No, this couldn't be real. They weren't going to stop him. He had come so far, he had to get out of there. But to his horror, a fifth spirit floated into the room. The spirit of a child he thought he would never see again. With tear tracks streaming down his face, the last child chased the murderer around the room, The purple man knew he had to get rid of them. It was his only way out of there. He then noticed the old animatronic laying on the floor. In an angry rage, he grabbed the suit and threw it on him. But the animatronic was obviously very, very old. And with the mixture of damp moisture in the air and not being used for such a long time, the spring lock that held the inner walls apart snapped shut, instantly killing the murderer of 11 children.
You would think this would be the end of our story, but it's not, because the spirits did not leave. Even though their murderer was killed, their salvation was not complete.
The spirit of the murderer now inhabited the old suit he was killed in, Spring Trap. So they returned to the heads of their disembodied suits and would wait until the last animatronic was destroyed for good. Freddy Fazbear's Pizza Chain was once and for all completely shut down, and the remaining parts were sold off to various auctioneers. 30 years later, some young adults heard the stories of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza and were quite interested in the creepy and scary mysteries they held. So, they decided to create a spooky haunted house called Fazbear's Fright, based on the Freddy Fazbear's Pizza Chain. So they went on a search to find some of the old merchandise and decorations of the place. They started off by finding some old knickknacks and 4 heads of the 4 old animatronics. Unbeknownst to them, the 4 heads carried 4 of the children's spirits. As more and more items were found and placed around the scary compound, another ghost, the ghost of the crying child, moved into the attraction as well. Once satisfied with their work, the young adults decide to hire a security guard to make sure that no one would break in before the attraction was opened, and to ensure that none of the old wiring they strung up would catch on fire. While on watch, the night guard started to have hallucinations of the old animatronics attacking him. Hardly a day later, the young adults were thrilled to find an old animatronic still in one piece that was hidden in one of the back rooms of the old buildings. This was the animatronic Spring Trap, and still had the spirit of the murderer trapped inside him. The adults placed him in one of their haunted rooms as the main attraction, and he was left to roam the haunted building at night.
Now this you will find interesting, because our story doesn't have one, but 2 endings.
Ending 1, the sad ending. As the days passed, Fazbear's Fright finally opens its doors to the public. The spirits of the 5 children watch on helplessly in the heads of their former animatronic bodies as the animatronic Spring Trap continues to walk the halls of the haunted house freely and continues to murder innocent people. The end. Ending 2, the happy ending. As the days pass, the spirits of the 5 children continue to haunt the security guard, which makes him fail to notice some of the faulty wiring in the building. Before Fazbear's Fright becomes open to the public, the entire place catches on fire, burning every last shred of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza into ashes, including Spring Trap and the spirit of the Purple Man. After so many years, the spirits of the 5 remaining children were at last at peace. While they could not have been saved from their evil murderer's grasp, they were able to save all future children from receiving the same fate. The last 5 children then disappeared forever.
The end. Now, as I said before, this story is definitely not 100% accurate. For one, there are still so many questions left unanswered. I hope you all enjoyed my story, because I don't know about you, but I have been officially creeped out. After looking up so many horrifying theories online, there is no way I am sleeping tonight.